The simplest questions are the hardest to answer. What exactly is nothing? The question would be puzzling since it implies that I'm trying to describe something. Yet nothing is not something. Instead, it is the absence of something. In 1929, Edwin Hubble discovered the universe is expanding. But what is it expanding into? It is an obvious question and the immediate answer is nothing. As some theoretical physicists suggest, our universe is not the only one out there. There are many, if not an infinite number of universes in a multiverse structure. The space between those universes could be naively imagined as nothing. Empty space has been used as an understanding of nothingness in physics and quantum mechanics. One could study empty space by chilling a container to absolute zero, shielding it from all external radiation, and sucking out every last molecule of air out of it. The container would just contain empty space. However, empty space turns out to be a lot more than nothing. No substance can reach absolute zero temperature. Zero Kelvin denotes the absence of any motion in the constituent particles of the substance. On the other hand, perfect stillness indicates that a particle's position and momentum are both determined simultaneously, which is impossible since it violates Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. If we fix a particle's position, its momentum and so its motion becomes a quantum blur of many different momenta, yielding a minimal average kinetic energy called zero point energy. As a result, the walls of our empty container will radiate a slight heat glow at all times, because this empty container actually contains quantum mechanical properties involving local quantum fields, virtual particles and energy that can and has been measured in experiments. How cool is that? Say, you have two celestial bodies floating in space separated by nothing but emptiness. Wouldn't that mean they were in contact with each other? And if not, then what exactly gives the space between them the property of distance? One way out of this is to say that there must be an unseen, frictionless medium permeating all of the space that serves as a frame of reference. This was referred to as the ether. It was a convenient way to explain how light waves get around. But if there really is an ether permeating all of space, then it should be possible to measure how fast Earth is traveling relative to it, right? But no experiment could measure this speed and there was no evidence to support it. Even if we hypothetically remove all particles, it will still contain the space-time continuum. Nothing is arguably better understood as the absence of even space-time, rather than space-time without anything in it.
Nothing doesn't necessarily create everything, but rather serves as the backdrop that allows everything, like a blank canvas is to a painting. Nothingness is to the existence of everything.